My name is Rogier van Doorn. I'm a clinical microbiologist from the Netherlands. I've been working in Vietnam for 10 years. I'm currently the director of the OUCRU unit in Hanoi. So the research we focus on in Hanoi is two main topics. We work on human and avian influenza, and we work on antimicrobial resistance of bacteria in both human diseases in hospitals, in communities, and in agriculture and the environment. So holistic approach to AMR. We established a household cohort 10 years ago in Hanam, which is 60 kilometers south of Hanoi. This is about 1,000 people. And we've been following them for 10 years, so we know very well about how often these people get flu. We know what kind of flu they get, which viruses are involved, and we know how their immune system responds to it. From what we learned in Hanam, we think we can predict what potential viruses may cause influenza the next season, and then we try to make those viruses in the lab and use those viruses for vaccination, and that's what we're going to trial in the next few years. And if that works, that will revolutionize the way we vaccinate people against flu. We've been awarded a grant from the Fleming Fund, from the UK government, to establish a national surveillance network for AMR, using a network of 16 hospitals. And alongside that, we're setting up, we're building, literally, a reference laboratory for AMR. We will be able to gather much more and much better data on AMR in Vietnam than we currently have. And that's important because Vietnam has been listed as one of the countries where AMR is the most pressing. It's, I think, third in the list after China and India. And the resistance mechanism that we see are the resistance mechanisms against our most broad drugs, last resort drugs. And those numbers are higher than in most other countries I've worked in that I've seen. How I see translational medicine is the use of data from research into something that can be used. We are using the Hanam cohort to learn about influenza, and a lot of the things we learned we are using to make vaccines in an entirely new way and then trial them in that cohort. On the avian influenza side, we've helped the Ministry of Agriculture, to set up a tool to follow the evolution of avian influenza viruses in a way that can be done in Vietnam. The existing methods were very sophisticated and could only be done in high-income countries using ferrets. We've set up a system to do it with chickens, which you can use in Vietnam, and that's now being used to directly monitor the evolution of avian influenza viruses, which is important because we think they may at some point cause a pandemic in humans. But it's also a very practical thing that we've contributed to developing. Our research is important in Vietnam on AMR, because AMR is perceived as a massive threat to human health because of the huge amount of antibiotic overuse that we see here. In high-income countries in Europe, we're used to only be prescribed antibiotics by a physician, and usually only when we're really ill. Here, antibiotics are used without restriction. They're available everywhere. There are 60,000 pharmacies in Vietnam, and you can buy antibiotics over the counter there, broad-spectrum antibiotics, and they're cheap, and everybody does it. If you would ask a cross-section of mothers with children under 5 whether their child has used antibiotics in the past month, more than 50% will say yes. So that gives you a bit of an idea of the scale of the problem. Because of this large amount of, let's say, use of antibiotics, you see a lot of resistance. And the resistance we see here is getting out of control. Patients are dying from it, children are dying from it. So working on that, trying to get better data and trying to use those data to inform government to change policy, change treatment guidelines, change the use of antibiotics through antibiotic stewardship programs is important for Vietnam, but also important globally because it may prevent further transmission of those resistant bugs outside of Vietnam.